Assalamualaikum students. This is your teacher Ms. Hina Kazi, lecturer Nutrition and Dietetics Department. Today I am going to explain you a very important and interesting topic, that is fat soluble vitamins for first year students. The learning objectives of this topic are importance of vitamins, classification of vitamins, different functions of vitamins, and how do we get these vitamins or their sources and their requirements according to different age groups. Their deficiency diseases, that if we do not have these vitamins for a prolonged time, what diseases can a person face, and their stability in food preparation, that means heating affects the nutritional value of these vitamins or not. Now students, now we first talk about the importance of overall vitamins. Basically, vitamins are a group of chemical substances that are very important to the body. Our body requires these vitamins, and most of them are not made by the body itself. So, a regular supply from diet is very necessary. Vitamins are required to regulate, maintenance and growth of the body, as well as they control metabolic reactions which are continuously taking place in our cells. So now the classification of vitamins. Basically, there are two types of vitamins. Fat soluble vitamins. In fat soluble vitamins, vitamin A, the chemical name for vitamin A is retinol. Vitamin D, the chemical name is cholecalciferol. Vitamin E, chemical name is tocopherol. And vitamin K. The next category is water soluble vitamins, in which all B complex vitamins and vitamin C or ascorbic acid, which is present in citrus fruits, is included. Now the functions of vitamin A or retinol. The most important function of vitamin A is that it is required to make a substance which is called as visual purple. And this visual purple is in the retina of the eye. And because of this visual purple, a person is able to see in dim light. This is a very important function of vitamin A. Next is, vitamin A is essential to keep the mucous membranes in the throat, digestive tract, bronchial and excretory systems, all these systems moist, and because of this lubrication, these systems will be free from infections. Vitamin A maintain healthy skin and is required for normal growth of children. Now the sources of vitamin A. Vitamin A is found as retinol in animal foods, that is liver, milk, egg yolk. In plant sources, vitamin A is found as beta carotene. And this beta carotene is specially found in carrots, green leafy vegetables, orange colored fruits, example mangoes, apricots. But in the human body, this beta carotene, which is obtained from the plant sources, is converted into retinol. And two parts of beta carotene is required to form one part of retinol. The learning objectives of this topic are importance of vitamins, classification of vitamins, different functions of vitamins, and how do we get these vitamins or their sources and their requirements according to different age groups. Their deficiency diseases, that if we do not have these vitamins for a prolonged time, what diseases can a person face, and their stability in food preparation, that means heating affects the nutritional value of these vitamins or not. Hello. Growth of the children will be retarded. Now vitamin D, functions of vitamin D. Cholecalciferol. Vitamin D is very important for the proper formation of bones and teeth. Because bones and teeth contain large amounts of minerals, calcium and phosphorus. Vitamin D helps to promote the absorption of these minerals, that is calcium and phosphorus. And after digestion, they are absorbed from the small intestine into the blood, which takes them to bones and teeth. Sources of vitamin D. Sunlight is a very important and chief source of vitamin D. When the body is exposed to the ultraviolet rays of the sun, a substance under the skin, dehydrocholesterol is converted to cholecalciferol, which is stored in the liver and is used whenever it is required. Other than this, it is found in good supply in cheese, margarine, butter, fortified milk, healthy cereals, and fatty fish. Now, the recommended dietary allowance RDA. For pregnant women, vitamin A is required 10 mg per day. For lactating women, vitamin D is required 10 mg per day. And for women which are 65 plus of age, vitamin D is required 10 mg per day. Deficiency of vitamin D. Now, the first deficiency we are going to discuss is rickets. It mainly affects the children. In this disease, absorption of the minerals, calcium and phosphorus is reduced. So, there is insufficient to maintain the strength of bones and teeth. And as a result, bones and teeth will become weak and the bones of the legs may bend under the weight of the body. Limb bones ke ends enlarge ho jate hain and the skull becomes fragile. And this is all happened in rickets and which is found in children. Second type of deficiency disease is found in adult, which is called as osteomalacia. In this disease, serious fractures result after even a minor fall. And plus, because of the deficiency of vitamin D, growth of the children is also retarded.